What's up guys, it's Kaustubhia, and today guys, as you have already seen the thumbnail and the title of this video, yes, this is my initial review of OxygenOS 11, which has been recently released for the OnePlus Nord, which is a stable release, by the way, guys. For a long time, it was in open beta stage, but now finally we have got the stable Android 11 working for the OnePlus Nord. So in this video, I'll be telling you all the new features that we get, and also I've been using this for a couple of days. We'll be telling you my experience with this and whether it is like, should you update to Android 11, which is OxygenOS 11, or you should wait on Android 10. So do watch the complete video till the end, guys. And just like always, make sure you hit that red subscribe button down below, as well as turn the notifications on so that you don't miss such amazing videos of the OnePlus Nord. With that being said, let's roll the intro and get the video started. So starting with all the new features that we get with OxygenOS 11, guys, first one being with the UI itself. So the UI has been refreshed quite a bit here and there. Small things have been changed, tweaked somewhat. And the main upgrade is with the settings app. So the whole setting app has been completely redesigned. As you can see, it looks pretty similar to that of One UI. I know that, guys. And other than that, the setting app, everything is pretty handy now. Some things have been shuffled here and there, but nonetheless, the setting app is absolutely fine. The security patch, if you ask me about the security patch, then the security patch is still running on the old January 2021. Security patch. So soon, I hope that will also get updated as well. Next change is mainly with the power menu, guys. As you can see, the power menu has been completely redesigned. And at first, I was not able to figure out, but then I came to know that it has an Android 11 Easter egg game built into the power menu itself. So it is a crazy game in which you get to see a cat, and that's all. Next big thing, guys, is with the ambient display. And finally, the main big feature, which is always on display, is finally there on OxygenOS running devices. On OnePlus devices, this feature was missing for quite a long time, but finally we get to see this feature on the OnePlus Nord in its full glory, guys. Other than that, we get to see new ambient clock style designs, which looks really cool. Other than this, there is also a customization menu in which everything has been sorted really well. And in this, we get to see this canvas wallpaper option, which I found to be really cool. Like the transition it does from the white outline to your actual phone wallpaper looks really cool. So I found that it is basically a new feature that we get in the customization menu. Talking about the third thing, guys, is again to do with another most awaited feature, which is automatic dark mode. Yes, we get it finally on OxygenOS 11. And in this, basically, if you don't know what automatic dark mode is, you can basically set a custom time range as to when the phone should start dark mode and when it should stop and switch to light mode. So that you get custom time ranges there, or automatically also it can do that for you. Also another thing, a quick nice handy feature is that OxygenOS 11 also has this new dark mode setting tile, or quick setting tile, in the quick setting panel above. So that's also a nice addition to the whole UI. Last new thing, guys, is with the shelf. So now on, the shelf will no more come from the left side of the screen, but it will come from the top, which is from the notification shade. And at first it was a bit annoying to me, but anytime you can disable it from the home settings menu, so not a big issue. So this whole shelf UI has been completely redesigned, as what OnePlus says. And also, guys, the weather widget and the most of the system widgets have also been redesigned to look good in the shelf menu. Next big thing and the final thing is to do with the gallery app. So the whole gallery app has been redesigned completely, guys, and they have given it a Instagram story kind of a look, in which the gallery app itself will create a bunch of story like a feature inside the app, and you can view it on a weekly basis. But I found the gallery app to be a pretty I didn't like the look of it, basically what I meant to say. Like the previous gallery app, which used to directly show me all of my photos in folders, was really good. But with this one, the whole UI has been changed. So some of you might like it, some of you might don't. I personally didn't like it that much, but anyways, you will get used to it over time, so not a big issue at all. Okay, so now, guys, that I've almost told you all of the new features that you get to see with OxygenOS 11, now I'll be talking about my experience with OxygenOS 11 on the OnePlus Nord. The day this new software was released, the new ROM stable release was given for the OnePlus Nord, I've been using it from that exact day till now. So it's been almost like 5 to 6 days as of shooting this video right now, guys. And my experience, in one word, if I have to say, it was really good. I didn't face any sort of issues. Like everything was pretty stable. Everything is working absolutely fine. You can obviously daily drive this ROM without any issue. Like, it is a stock ROM, it is not a custom ROM. So guys, the one issue which a lot of people reported is like they are getting delayed notifications from certain apps, especially social media apps. So the fix for this issue is that you should just go into the app info of the app which you're facing issue with and go into the battery section. And in that, just click on don't optimize. Yes, this will affect the battery life, but at least you will get timely notifications. So this delayed notification issue was there in the open beta version of this OxygenOS 11. And in that version, like in open beta 3, this was really bad. Like, the notifications were really, really delayed. But with this stable release, I felt it was not that much of a big issue. Like, I was almost getting timely notifications without any tweaking done. Also, if you're facing any other issue than this, then I would simply recommend you guys just do a complete factory reset, because most of the people, just to avoid the hassle of backing up their data and again restoring it, just lazily just don't do a factory reset and just use it as it is, just upgrading it from Android 10 to Android 11. But guys, just do a factory reset and that will almost fix almost all of the issues that you might be facing with your device. Next thing guys is with the battery backup. So a lot of people are usually concerned on the Android side after an update, like the battery takes a hit, SOT goes down. But in the case, in my experience, I didn't felt it that much. Like for my kind of usage, in which I basically use a lot of social media apps, then watching a lot of YouTube videos and doing some phone calls here and there. I don't play games a lot, guys. So in that kind of usage, I was getting around 6 to 6.5 hours of screen on time, which is pretty decent, I should say. It was easily getting me throughout a day without the need of charging again. So battery wise, it won't disappoint you at all. And lastly guys, talking about is with the camera. The whole camera UI or the whole camera app has been redesigned quite a bit. You can see it with the shutter button, like the design of the shutter button has changed. Also the UI has been tweaked here and there with the like the video options and small things have been changed. You can see that for yourself. The new feature which I felt is with the preview button. So as you can see on the right side of the shutter button, you get to see the photo preview, and if you keep that clicked, then you get this share button, like a circular bar comes up in which you can share your photo directly by swiping on the tab and into that app. So that's a neat little touch, I think. This is a new feature which you get to see in this new OxygenOS 11. So guys, finally concluding the video, and what my opinion is that if you are a OnePlus Nord user and if you're still on Android 10, don't get worried, you will also get the OxygenOS 11 update really soon. And if you are really, really enthusiastic about this OxygenOS 11 and you want to get it immediately, then you can also manually install OxygenOS 11 onto your OnePlus Nord. So to do that, I have left a link in the description down below. So just download the OxygenOS 11 zip file and then you have to flash it through the settings app. So it's pretty simple, not a big thing. And after doing that, just guys, do a factory reset, otherwise you will face some small minor hiccups or some issues. So yeah, that's about it for my review of the OxygenOS 11 on the OnePlus Nord. And this is an initial review. A full review will be soon coming out as well, guys. So if you are planning, like if you've got the update and if you haven't upgraded, just do it. You will be absolutely amazed with the newest update of OxygenOS 11. So yeah, guys, that's about it for this review. And if you have liked this video, then please do hit the like button down below. And guys, also do consider subscribing to my channel by hitting that red subscribe button down below, as well as turn the notifications on so that you don't miss such amazing videos. With that being said, this is your boy Kaustubia from Tech2Explore signing off. Until then, keep exploring.